Hello students, how are you? I hope you all are fit and fine. So dear students, in my previous video, I have discussed transformation of sentences and it was the last video on this topic. Today we are going to learn reported speech, as this is very important topic in your English grammar and you have been studying this topic, I think from your sixth class. Even though during copy correction, I find many students they are confused regarding while writing a sentence into indirect narration. So they make mistake regarding pronouns. They make mistakes regarding tenses. They make mistakes regarding punctuation marks. So this reported speech will cover all these things. And I hope if you really pay attention what I am going to teach, what we are going to discuss, okay, what we are going to learn today, if you really pay attention, then you won't make such silly mistakes. Because of that, your marks get deducted. Okay. So let's begin this important topic in your English grammar, that is reported speech. Reported speech is also known as direct and indirect narration. Reported speech is also known as direct and indirect narration. What is direct narration? What is a direct narration? Let us discuss first. If the message is conveyed by the second speaker using the exact word which has been spoken by the first speaker, which has been spoken by the real speaker, if using exact word the same message is conveyed, okay, by using the exact word, so that is called direct narration. For example, Raghav says Priya is absent today. Raghav says Priya is absent today. So here, dear students, you can see that the second speaker is conveying the message using the exact words spoken by the first speaker. So that is why it is said to be in direct narration. Now what is indirect narration? In indirect narration, the same message is conveyed but by not using the exact word. Some changes regarding tenses and pronouns are done to convey the same message but not in exact word. So that is called indirect narration. For example, Raghav says that Priya is absent today. Raghav says that Priya is absent today. So what change we can see when we compare these two sentences? Their meaning is same, but formation is in a different way. Okay, so we can see the change in sentence formation. In the first one, Raghu says Priya is absent today. When here someone is conveying the same message which Raghu has said, someone is conveying the same message which Raghav has said using the exact words which Raghav has said. What has Raghav said? Raghav has said Priya is absent today. And another speaker is also using the exact word. He is also saying Raghav says Priya is absent today. Okay? In the second one, we can see that here the speaker has made some change. What is the change? The speaker has removed comma and inverted commas and replaced it with conjunction that. Now speaker is conveying the same message but not in exact words. Raghav says that Priya is absent today. So here we can see that a change has been made in indirect narration. Okay? So dear students, there are certain rules regarding changing a sentence from direct narration to indirect narration. So one by one, we are going to discuss all the rules. Okay, so first of all, before beginning the discussion regarding all the rules, we must know two things which are very important. First, we must know how to identify reporting verb and reported speech. So let's see what is reporting verb and what is reported speech. So dear students, let's first divide this sentence into two parts. Okay, this is part one and that one part two. Let us divide this sentence into two parts. Now dear students, this verb which has been used in part one before this comma, this verb is called reporting verb. We must keep it remember. This verb is called reporting verb, while the statement which has been written within double inverted comma, it is called reported speech. I'm writing RS in short. So this statement which has been written within double inverted comma, it is called reported speech. And the verb which has been written just before comma in part 1, it is called reporting verb. Okay? And this subject, we call it reporter. This subject is called reporter. Okay, so two things we must remember here, reporting verb and reported speech. Because the rules which we are going to discuss, these two words play a very important role. All the changes in reported speech are, all the changes in reported speech take place according to reporting verb. It means reporting verb will decide what changes will take place in reported speech. Okay, changes will take place in the second part in reporting verb, but it will be decided by reporting verb. Changes will take place in reported speech. Regarding what type of changes will take place in reported speech? regarding tenses, regarding pronouns. Okay? And these changes will be decided by reporting verb. Reporting verb will decide whether the changes regarding tense or regarding pronouns will take place in reported speech or not. So that is why I am emphasizing again and again that we should know about reporting verb and reported speech. Okay? Now, let's start with rule number one. So we are going to discuss some rules regarding changing a statement from direct to indirect. So there are certain rules regarding it. So one by one, we are going to discuss them. Rule one. Remove by removing while changing, you know, let me write here, or please write down rules regarding changing from direct to indirect narration. Rules, let me write here either. Rules regarding change from direct to indirect narration. Okay? Rules regarding change from direct to indirect narration. So please take the screenshot or you can pause the video and write down. Now we are going to discuss the rules. Rule number one. By removing comma and inverted comma, by removing comma and inverted comma, conjunction that is used. Okay, number one. What is now number two? Say to is converted into tell, says to into tells, and said to into told. Okay? By removing comma and inverted comma, conjunction the is used. Say to is changed into tell, says to into tells, and said to into told. One thing we must remember, we must keep it remember, that these say, says, or said, they will be converted into tell, tells, told only when they are followed by to. If they are not followed by to, then they will not be converted into tell, tells, or told. Says to, said to. If they are not followed by to, then they will not be converted. They will remain same. Okay? If they are followed by to, then they will be converted into tell, tells, and told respectively. Got? So either you can take the screenshot or write down. Okay? I'm going to rub it and write more rules and examples regarding it.
third rule, if reporting verb, if reporting verb is in present tense, if reporting verb is in present tense, then the tenses of, or let me write in singular, then the tense of reported speech is not changed.
If reporting verb, that part which we have just discussed, the part which just comes before the comma, okay, that part is reporting verb. So if reporting verb is in present or future tense, then the tense of reported speech, sorry, I have forgot to write here, it should be speech here, please write it down. The tense of reported speech is not changed. Okay, so now let us go through the examples to understand it better. First one, Ravi says Vijay is my best friend. Ravi says Vijay is my best friend. So it is in direct narration. So let us convert it into indirect narration. Ravi says, let us recall the rule. What is the first rule? Remove comma and inverted commas, and we should write conjunction that here. Okay, so by removing comma and inverted comma, we should write conjunction that, and this says will remain same. It will remain says because it is not followed by to. If it is followed by to, then it is changed into tells. But here it is not followed by to. Okay, so Ravi says that Vijay is, this my will be changed into his. So changes regarding pronoun we will discuss later. Okay, Vijay is his best friend. Okay, so here students, we can see that reporting verb is in present tense. That is why the tense of reported speech is not changed. It remains the same. As we have just discussed that if reporting verb is in present tense, or we should write here, beta. If reporting verb is in present tense or future tense, or future tense. Okay. So please add here, if reporting verb is in present tense or future tense, then the tense of reported speech is not changed. So here, reporting verb, Ravi says, in which tense it is? Ravi says, so it is in simple present tense. So simple present means present. So it is in present tense. So that is why the tense of reported speech will not be changed. So take the screenshot, or you can pause the video and write down. Then I will rub it and discuss more examples. Okay, so I hope you have done it.
Next one, direct. Priyanka says to me, Pinku, is not studying properly. Priyanka says to me, comma, inverted comma, Pinku is not studying properly. Now let us change it into indirect narration. So Priyanka now says to.
So what we have just discussed, if say says to or said, if say says or said, they are followed by to, then they will be changed into tell, tells and told respectively. So says to will be changed into tells here, tells me, remove commas and write conjunction that.
So Priyanka tells me that Pinku is not studying properly. So dear students, once again we can see that the tense is not changed.
Do you know why? Because reporting verb is in which tense? Present tense. So if reporting verb is in present tense, then the tense of reported speech will not be changed. If the tense of reporting verb, whether in present tense or in future tense, then the tense of reported speech is not changed. Okay? So let me write four examples. You can take the screenshot or you can pause the video and write it down. I'm going to rub it now.
Third one. Pankaj will say Hari Om has not completed his project in English.
Pankaj will say Hari Om has not completed his project in English. Let us convert it into indirect narration.
So what is the first thing we are going to do? Pankaj will say, it will remain the same because it is not followed by to. Okay, so Pankaj will say, now remove comma and inverted comma and write conjunction that Hari Om. Now let us check whether the tense will be changed or not. So who will decide? Reporting verb will decide. Reporting verb is in future tense, then the tense of reported speech will not be changed, it will remain the same. So that is why Pankaj will say that Hari Om has not completed his project in English. So dear students, once again let me tell you that this part will decide whether the tense of reported speech will be changed or not. If this part is in present, if this part means reporting verb, if reporting verb is in present or future tense, then the tense of reported speech will not be changed. Okay, let us go through more examples to understand it better. Fourth one, I have said to him, I have said to him, he will surely pass the exam. Inverted comma closed. I have said to him, he will surely pass the exam. Let us change. It is a direct narration. Let us change into indirect narration. I have now said to. Said to will be changed into told. I have told him. Now remove commas and inverted commas. And what should be written? That he. Now, whether the tense will be changed or not. So let us check the tense of reporting verb. So reporting verb is in present perfect tense. So present perfect tense means in present tense. So if reporting verb is in present or future tense, then the tense of reported speech is not changed. So we are not going to change the tense of reported speech. It will remain the same. Okay. So he will surely pass the exam. Okay. Is it clear? So you can take the screenshot or you can pause the video and write down. So dear students, what we have discussed in today's video as of now we have discussed that while changing a sentence from direct to indirect narration, we should remember certain rules regarding it. We have gone through three rules. According to that, first of all, we have to remove commas and inverted commas, and we should write conjunction the in order to join reporting verb to reported speech. The part which is written just before comma, this one is called this verb of this part. We can divide into two parts. The part which is written just before the comma, the verb in this part is called reporting verb, while the whole statements given by the speaker given by the reporter, it is called reported speech.
So whether the tense of reported speech will be changed or not, it will be decided by the tense of reporting verb. If the tense of reporting verb is in present or future, then the tense of reported speech will not be changed. Okay? Say to will be changed into tell, says to into tells, and said to into told. If they are not followed by, if say, says, and said, they are not followed by to, in that condition, they will not be changed into tell, tells, or told. They will remain same. So it's all about today's video. In my next videos, I will discuss more rules regarding change of direct narration to indirect narration. So thank you students for watching the video. Please keep watching the video and keep practicing, because without practice you won't be able to learn the things properly. Practice is very important. So thank you for watching the video. See you tomorrow.